good. Breaking down the base. So I'm going to analyze what she's doing. Trying to do this. Trying to get her hips in low. Had she got her hips in, there we go, a little more, then it works really well. So now you can see here, good hooking pressure, and she's just not gonna let me have that. A lot of pressure. See, when your ribs are contracted on the side, lots of pressure. They're not meant to go this way with ease, like on your back or your stomach. They compress that way normally. So I've got to shift my hips with that a little lower center of gravity, but also with an escape. Yes, she leads it in. Got to pry them out. So people would think, oh, just strike her in the head. Not easy to do. Can't do that from here. But I can work finger locks, because finger locks work well in situations like this. Hips low, because if I get too high, I feel she was already starting to lift me. So here's another one. She's bracing this. Watch. Inside, press it up. Okay, and that's the way to go. Just slip underneath, press underneath. I replace the actual position of here, leverage in a little bit, right down to where my hand becomes the thing she has to grab. Keeping my center of gravity low, because she's got, if she gets under me, she can lift me pretty well. I trained them to do this. They're strong as heck, but I train them for that too. And leveraging lifts. Good control. Now I have to use this with an eye towards an elbow. Good control. Look at that. I can't go to bind. Nice. So I slipped up underneath, got a nice position. It's good and taxing. So this is after our boot camp on the monkey bars. Working for a little bit of elbow strike on the IT band. That's always good to get a person to remind is there. Elbow, because she forgot. There we go. So this is part of the process. I won't let her hands get through if I can help it. So I interrupt that. She does that again. Lift goes, sits in like that. Here's the hook. There's the hook. So now she lifts. She lifts against herself. So that's what you got to do. That gets that lift in there right away. Okay. Now, even if she grabs that, that's a good bind. So tucking my arm underneath, she could leverage her shoulder and force me down that way a little bit more. So I gotta go where the fingers open, turn it out like this, assault the face. Don't let her get too far away because she's got some wicked knees. Good grip. Got the hips in nice and tight. That's it. I can go over. Okay. There's a lot going on here you don't see. There's a lot of pressure that if she's off a little bit, I can capitalize on that. Just very small things you don't get to see on the outside all the time. Yeah. And she knows if she gives me a little bit, I'm gonna take it. Gotta get lower. Yeah. That's how you disrupt the base. That's how you disrupt the base. But start the lock here with the hand, like you're gonna go underneath, and an elbow instead. Yeah, that's right. And then go like that. Bam. Fatigue now. Russian red belly. That's right. See, it's not over till it's over. Got a good control on the clothing, on the wrist, a good strong control. I can't punch well without her getting there. So you're not dead till you're dead. And in this case, if I'm at all complacent, those are nice drives right to the proper location and the jaw and throat. Stomach. Good pressure. Get out of here. You will be called upon for every muscle you've got in your body for strength. So yeah, there we go. That's good. So it's not as easy as you think because my legs are wrapped around trying to keep her from getting a good base. The other is she's got good binding hook control here on this surface, which I can't shift my hips really well because of that. If I were to unhook the leg, that makes it a little more free, but that also makes her free to do things like that, where she couldn't have before because I hooked the leg and was pressing her down. But now that I released the leg, she can throw the head in. But that's where we start working a little of the BJJ. But the head under the jaw strikes actually matter. So we underhook the leg here, a little to the throat. There we go. Get back out to this position. Oh, nice control. But I don't let her grip. Replay foot. Thank you. That's it. And bye. Yes. Oh, good knee. Good control on the arm. You can use that more. Yep. Oh yeah, good. Good binding pressure. Mm-hmm. Keeps my arm out. But yeah, but this is where it would be a problem. So this might look good for BJJ or might look good for some people in grappling. But if you think about this, I can go like this and then clean her head right off on that corner. So that's where grappling and trying to stand guard is a bad idea. Because it'd just take one hit like that, unconscious or worse. So she needs to get off. Switch. There you go. That's it. Good control. Yes! Back to where she knows control is. Shifting. Hooking. There we go. Yes! There we go. Takes her shoes off. Elbows and elbows. So we want her to remember where her stomach is. Good. I thought she was going to go for her shin. It's the simple things that are sometimes just right there. A good instructor on the outside will see that, will be able to point that out. So if you're struggling, that outside perspective and experience perspective will do really well for you. It'll help you go, oh yeah, there it is. Even if the instructor is in the mix, they can feel that and tell you exactly where to go.